In the chat room, this song is for us. We go from the floor up. What's up? Oh, it's just another day in the chat room with Robin Lynn, playing independent artists again. She doing the gosh darn thing, playing back, man, yeah. Oh, it's just another day in the chat room. Symphony, EPMD, independent artists, Mr. Push Spoodles, running down productions. Turn up. Get up in the morning with my 9 to 5. Hop on my computer, yo, it's Vibes Live. You want back? Peeping new music underground from the ground up. That's how we doing it. I got this. Vibes, yo, slow it down. Yo, I got this. Nutso, holding it down. Rugger Real got the thugger, so it's real. Lil Hayes dropping heat from the page. Ezra knocking out opponents, holy fail. The challenger bringing 808 scale. DJ Antron 24/7 whistle blown. Bringing back the tracks that's well known. Call it Brian Concha spitting on the microphone. For the chat room, turn it up. Oh, it's just another day in the chat room with Robin Lynn. Playing independent artists again. She doing the gosh darn thing. Playing back, man, yeah. Oh, it's it's just another day in the chat room. Symphony, EPMD, independent artist, Mr. Bush Spood, who's running down productions. Turn up. Game day, no exclusives. Spoodles got you going like the ladies popping, prove it. Dope song, conversating in the chat room, movement. Y'all feeling what we doing? Not to confuse you like a college student. Congruent to our steps to bring the union movement. Baby girl on the hooks, like look what she's doing. Fuzz dog on the beats, get you into it. A&R promoters, get your engines revving. Independent artists, moving close with the stepping. Call it Willie Brown, Florida heat dropping, West Coast sound. From the ground up, you like how we round up. Fight music in the house, movie soundtrack, put it in your film. Talk back, guarantee you can't have been a track of verse back. We got dicks like that. Oh, it's just another day in the chat room with Robin Lynn, playing independent artists again. And she doing the gosh darn thing, play it back, man, yeah. Oh, it's just another day in the chat room. Symphony, EPMD, independent artist, Mr. Bush Spood, who's running down productions. Turn up. Blue faces. Blue faces. Blue faces.
Mr. Old School back. I bought from my time, I got my old school rap. In my color stays, I got my old school rap. In the backseat is a whole tool back. I'm on my overnight shit. Turning up these bottles in the nightclub, bitch. Step on my shoes, it's not a fight club, bitch. If your homies running up, I got a right slow. Walking in the mall and all I got is blue faces. Sitting in my pocket is a bunch of blue faces. Showing stripper love and all I throw is blue faces. When you getting money, run into some new faces. I'm on my overnight shit. Before I buy a key, I make them scatter right quick. It's Mr. Motivation, I was made like this. Why the fuck you haters think I'm paid like this? Miami to Minnesota, and the shit won't bubble unless you mix it with the soda. Gucci Louis on my shoulder, put some hustle in your life. Just bought a Rolex, cause want your own bitch life. Still riding in the hood, cause I'm filling up these blocks. And the fans can't find it, cause it's hidden in my shocks. Stuff a bag full of money, made a whip so clean. Made 10 in the week, nigga, shout out to the team. It seem like all these hoes wanna cuff a nigga bread. Staring at my blue faces like the shit turned red. Look, laying at my fucking chain, hanging down from my neck. Still chilling every hood, cause they showed me respect. You can plays in the game, call me Tyler Bear, serving pro to the fiends. Call me Jim Carrey, black tee, black fitted, plus my wrist tatted up. But what's sitting on my wrist is worth about 100 plus. I'm on my overnight shit. Turning up these bottles in the nightclub, bitch. Step on my shoes, it's not a fight club, bitch. If your homies running up, I got a right slug, bitch. Walking in the mall and all I got is blue faces. Sitting in my pocket is a bunch of blue faces. Showing stripper love and all I throw is blue faces. When you getting money, you run into some new faces.
Calling to a nigga like me, shit. It's 900 in my stash, all a nigga do. Drop my own hood, call me local. Pass through customs.
Pass through customs.
Keep the coffee ground in the bag like cocoa. I got that hook up, nigga. 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 I got that hook up, nigga.
What?
I got that hook up, nigga. Make a car triple when I cook up, nigga. I got that hook up, nigga.
Pills got hard, got speed, got the need to. Pills got hard, got speed, got the need to. Pills got hard, got pills, got hard, got pills, got pills, got pills, got pills, got pills, got hard, got speed, got the need to. Turn to the boost while I blow our teams up the whole block like thousand crack fiends. Blue magic come around, trap boom, what that mean?
Son,
I got the hook up, nigga. Surf the whole city, got the cook up, nigga. Got it on lock, nigga. Plus the whole city got a sugar, nigga. Coming for bagged up, tired, I'm ready, put it down. Double up, big size, coming back, bolt. Re-up, looking good, got Molly Cole. What you looking for, nigga? Got it right here, nigga. Got what you need, nigga. Let me cool it down, got you right, nigga.
I got that hook up, nigga. I got that hook up, nigga. Counting on my trap fill, black cat, black feel, rocking all these black pills, bad bitch out here, light skin, black hair, selling green, white pills, nigga, that's rare. Come and Scarface, nigga, them pills drag like a car race, nigga. Feds never seen our face, nigga, and the money keep flowing like a heart rate, nigga.
Man,
say what?
I don't know about y'all, but I can tie police ass niggas, man.
Me too, nigga.
You know the one I'm talking about.
Oh, bitch ass.
Them old pig face ass motherfucking snitching ass, old swine ass niggas, man.
Make me sick in my stomach.
What would happen if you didn't follow the established path? Would you feel scared or proud? Could you explain that helping the people of Peru improve their own community would also have an effect on your own? Would you rather make your own way? I spend a lifetime saying, what if? Life is calling. How far will you go? Peace Corps. To find out more, call 1-800-424-8580 or go to peacecorps.gov.
Miley Cyrus, whose nude appearance in the music video for her hit song Wrecking Ball that made waves in 2013, is back in the buff, this time for Paper Magazine's summer 2015 issue. Cyrus graces the cover of Paper wearing nothing but mud and covering her body by hugging a strategically placed pig. The photos show the former Hannah Montana star fully nude and wearing body paint. It isn't all for show, according to Cyrus, who says that she posed nude to support the Happy Hippie Foundation, a philanthropic endeavor that she founded to help raise funds and awareness for homeless and LGBT youth. Cyrus also discusses her own same-sex attractions, recalling to her mother at age 14 that she felt romantic feelings towards other females. The Miley Cyrus cover comes on the heels of the much-talked-about spread in Paper's winter issue, which made waves with a nude Kim Kardashian displaying her oiled backside on the cover.
Go. Watson had left, and the tourists had come back to Baker Street to catch a glimpse of the real Sherlock Holmes.
Was that him?
I had seen Sherlock Holmes with the hat and the pipe.
This Holmes, Mr. Holmes, is 93 years old when we first meet him at the end of a long life of retirement. And he's trying to solve his last mystery, the one that he didn't quite complete when he was in his heyday. So I get to play Holmes young and middle-aged, so that makes it slightly superior to other versions.
Okay, Watson, if I ever write a story myself, it will be to correct the myriad misconceptions created by his imagination.
Did you write such a story?
I'm trying to do so now.
When you don't work, you can do lovely things like see friends and go to the theatre and travel. And I like doing all those things. So I don't aim to earn 12 months of the year, but 6 or 8 months.
I'm shouldn't live this life that sense of completion.
British rock band Muse scored their fifth British number one album on Sunday when Drones went straight into the chart at the top spot, according to the official charts company. The cut features the singles Dead Inside and Mercy and sold almost 73,000 copies, pushing Florence and the Machine's How Big, How Blue, How Beautiful down one place to number two. Jason Derulo's Want to Want Me was the top-selling single for the third consecutive week. The track, which is Derulo's fourth chart topper following In My Head in 2010, Don't Wanna Go Home in 2011 and Talk Dirty in 2013, ended the week with more than 11,000 sales of its nearest competitor, Omi's Cheerleader.
Trial kicked off this week that could have the whole legal community quaking. It involves an accounting scandal at Dewey and LaBeouf. Bren, you're saying this may not just be confined to Dewey and LaBeouf, even though these are the guys who are on
trial. Well, now let's step back. We remember Dewey and LaBeouf. That's the biggest law firm bankruptcy ever, 2012. Whole firm collapsed. A lot of
1,300
lawyers at its peak. And you know, the direct cause is they tried to get, you know, into the big leagues. They tried to be a Cravath and a Skadden and hire. They tried to merge, hire all these expensive lateral partners, big names, paid them, you know, just outrageous partner draws, didn't have enough money, and started to fiddle with the accounting. Now, the people responsible for that are now on trial on criminal charges.
Three senior guys.
Senior guys, the former chairman, a CFO, and the executive director. Now, the problem is law firm accounting is really fuzzy. I mean, they have, you know, they use what's called modified cash accounting. And that gives them a lot of leeway about when to recognize
expenses. It's
about
expenses, when the fees come in and when
the expenses. You know, how long to amortize capital expenditures and equipment, what to do with partner fees, how to handle recruitment fees. A lot of discretion, which is fine because all these businesses are different. Every firm is different. As long as you disclose what you're doing, as long as it makes the financials clearer, that's okay. All firms do this. But if there's so much leeway and so much pressure on law firms now to show good profit, because the law, you know, of course, the law business is pretty bad these days, or it was in recent years, that there's a lot of abuse going on.
And the allegations here are that they were sort of stretching the bounds. Of,
well, yeah, you know, I mean, here's the big thing. I mean, the firm started running out of money, so they went to lenders, they went to banks, they issued
and
bonds.
To do that,
law
they
firms
to,
just don't. They needed financials.
And they needed to show some numbers.
So they cooked up the numbers, and the allegations are that they, you know, materially misled the banks.
And one of the things that comes up
the
is you mentioned is that the revenue number in particular shows up in one place as one number and somewhere else as something else.
Yeah, I mean, American Lawyer, of course, is sort of the Bible of who's making what in the law firm world. And they reported one number, one annual revenue number north of $900 million to the American Lawyer. But to their own partners, they reported about $700-some-odd million.
So they don't understand where that
And the American Lawyer asked them about it. I said, well, you know, how do you get this number? And they said, well, they're just not comparable. It's like, no kidding, they're not comparable. They never really explained that. Obviously, they've used different methods to arrive at the two. Which method was okay? Which method wasn't okay? This is the kind of stuff that law firms will be very interested in finding out.
All right.
Outside of doing.
We will leave it there. We'll keep an eye on that, as will the legal community. And we'll be back with more Breaking Views next week.
Intel announced this morning that it's spending almost $17 billion to buy Altera, the third big chip deal we've seen this year. And Richard, you've been looking at some of these, and but there are reasons for these deals. We can go through that. But the intriguing thing is what these guys seem to be promising financially.
Right. Well, these guys and the investors who've pushed up, you know, in these three deals, the stock of all six companies, if you look at them before the deal and then before there was any talk of a deal, and then after, you know, sometimes acquirers' stocks go down, especially if they pay big premiums. Intel's is the biggest premium; it's 50% plus,
right,
at least by one measure. But these have all gone up. I think it's generally seen as overdue. There's consolidation in the sector, and so on. You know, growth has not been strong, etc. So that's all fine. So
of course, the theory behind a lot is that if growth isn't strong, then these deals can come together and get a lot of value from
synergies.
Cutting costs.
Right. So two kinds of synergies, and it's what one of our mottos here. Cost synergies, we kind of believe. Revenue synergies, we tend to be more skeptical.
Yep.
So you can cut costs, sure. And a lot of companies do succeed in doing that, although maybe not actually on the scale they expect. The selling synergies is a different thing. Can you sell more? Can Intel sell more Altera chips just because it's Intel? It's kind of part of the question. Or maybe if there's more consolidation, do you have more pricing power? Do all these companies have more pricing power? So some combination of those things seems to be featuring here, that if the market values of these six companies has gone up by more than $30 billion, if you, depending exactly where you start and finish, but let's say, well under half that is accounted for by the synergies these companies have, the cost cuts these companies have talked about. So the rest must be investors thinking, okay, they can sell more or they can sell at a higher price.
And Intel put some numbers on this, which basically kind of jives in with the numbers you did.
Well, Intel didn't quite say whether what it thought its value creation was going to be was the premium it paid, but let's not worry about that too much right now. They said 60% will be essentially revenue synergies and 40% is cost and efficiency synergies. So they're kind of saying the same thing. We think we can sell more or at a better price or a product that people will pay more for by combining with this other company.
And yeah, we can look back over the history of deals over the last 15, 20 years and find loads of examples where companies promised revenue synergies and they never really arrived. In fact, I think bank industry used to do this in the 1990s, and then they realized that they're getting nervous.
Citi and Travelers is always one of my favorite examples. They thought they could sell all the bank branch customers insurance, and it turned out maybe they didn't want specifically that insurance, so they wanted something else. And that's obviously the danger here. You know, Intel likes to talk a lot about Moore's Law and how their chips get better and better, faster and faster. Well, the problem is that, that's all great, and this transaction may help that happen, but they also tend to get cheaper.
Right.
Ultimately, the computing power gets cheaper. So whether Intel can convert this into higher, bigger top line is a question. Same applies to the others.
Yeah. All right. Thanks for talking us through that, and we'll be back with more Breaking Views tomorrow.
I love Bob's Live. I said, yo, can you kick it?
Yes, I can.
I love Vibes Live.
So do I.
Don't even suspect, could probably care less.